Hi friends, welcome to another new video of Varomic. Today we are going to discuss about 16 different parts of a compound microscope. You already know the different types of microscopes used in the field of science. That video is uploaded in the top gadgets and techniques playlist. You can watch it later. Okay friends, of this video we are discussing about 16 different parts of a compound microscope. Part number 1, it's eyepiece. So what is eyepiece of a microscope? It is the lens the viewer looks through the specimen, and the eyepiece usually contains 10x or 15x power lenses. It is near to the eyes of the viewer of the observer, and generally its magnification is constant, either it is 10x or 15x or 5x, and other 16x magnifications are available. Generally they are constant and they can be changed as objective lens powers. And number 2 is diopter adjustment. So it is useful as mean to change the focus on IP so as to correct for any difference in vision between your two eyes. That if you look through two eyes, if there a blurring in the image or some sort of clarity problems, we can adjust it through by adjusting the diopter of the eyepiece lens. So this is the importance of diopter adjustment. And number 3 is body tube or head region of a microscope. It is usually connect the eyepiece and the objective lenses in a microscope, and it is a connection part between these two lens system. And number 4 is nose piece, and it is used to connect the objectives. It is a rotating turret that houses the objective lenses, and the viewer spin the nose piece to select different objective lenses of different powers. So we can spin this nose piece to choose different powers of objective lens. Then the 5th one is objective lenses. It's the lens system which is closer to the specimen, and it is standard. In standard microscope, it has 3, 4 or 5 objective lenses in that system, which ranges from 4x to 100x. Generally 4x, 10x, 40x, 100x magnifications are available as objective. And when focusing the microscope, be careful that the objective lens doesn't touch the slide, as it could break the slide and destroy the specimen. Then number 6 is the arm region of a microscope, and it is generally connect the body tube or the head region of microscope, which holds the objective and the eyepiece, to the base of the microscope, which support the whole part of a microscope. And the 7th region is Coates adjustment. It is used to general focusing of a specimen using a knob which we can spin or turn around, which adjusts the focus of the specimen in general terms. And number 8 is fine adjustment, and it is another knob just besides the Coates adjustment, which is used to fine tune the focus and increase the detail of specimen by slightly adjusting the fine adjustment knob. We can increase the clarity and the focus of the specimen, and we can get more detailed picture of the specimen. And number 9 is the stage, which is the platform which we held the microscopic slide for observing the specimen. And the number 10 is stage clips, which are placed in the stage, which is used for holding the microscopic slide. They are usually metal clips or maybe plastic. And the 11th part of a microscope is stage height adjustment or stage control system, which is used to adjust the left and right position of the stage, or up and down adjustment in a stage, and which is graduated scale and a knob system which we can turn around for adjusting the left to right movement and up and down movement of a stage. And number 12 is aperture, which is the hole region in the middle of stage that allows light from the illuminator to reach the specimen. And generally the aperture size is constant. We can control it using the condenser, changing the condenser part of the microscope. The 13th one is iris diaphragm. It acts like the iris in our eye. It adjusts the amount of light that reaches the specimen from the light source through the aperture. And the 14th one is condensers. Condensers are available in different numerical apertures. They are a lens system which focuses the light as I concentrate it into a cone of light that illuminates the specimen. Condensers are located above the light source and under the sample in an upright microscope, and above the stage and below the light source in an inverted microscope, and they act together to get the light from the microscope light source and concentrate it into a cone of light that illuminates the specimen. Number 15 is illumination or light source, which is generally an artificial light source. The light source for a microscope, in older microscope, they used mirrors to reflect light from external source up through the bottom of the stage. However, most microscope now use low voltage bulb and a control system for changing the intensity or power of the bulb. And the final part is the base, which holds the full weight of a microscope, and an illuminator system which having the intensity knob for controlling the intensity of illuminator or light source, and an on-off switch for controlling this light source. So this is the whole picture of a microscope, which is compound microscope, and the important 16 parts in this compound microscope. And guys, I hope that you enjoy this video and understand the major parts of a microscope. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel and click the bell icon for further notifications of new videos. And please like and share this video and follow our Facebook and Instagram page. So guys, till then, bye bye.